Hello guys, we're back with a brand new video. I'm Kai from Wondershare Demo Creator, and we publish useful videos on how-to topics regularly. So if you find our videos helpful and haven't subscribed to our channel yet, make sure you do and hit the little bell button to never miss an update from us. In today's video, I'll be showing you three tips to help you train your teams and clients online. Training is an incredibly important part of any workforce, whether you're training your teams on things like internal processes, or whether you're training your teams or clients on how to use a product. Companies are increasingly turning to virtual training as a way to better reach their audience. So let's talk about the three best practices to help you take your remote training to the next level. So the first tip is to use great visuals. And the goal of any training session is to help your audience learn something, and more importantly, retain that information for when they need it. People won't remember anything if you simply run through your slides full of text. You need to support your message with strong images or videos that create a memorable impact. Have a look at this example here. So hello everybody, today we're going to be learning three tips for remote training online. We'll look at why online training is important, why using great visuals is important, and also why organizing your training and being entertaining is important as well. So that didn't seem very interesting, did it? And that was partly due to the visuals. We want to make a visual impact and not just use bullet-pointed lists. Additionally, be sure to adapt your content to the medium. Too often people try to replicate an in-person experience for their remote training sessions, which can have mixed results. Talking over occasional visuals can work well when everyone's in the same room, but doing that remotely can cause your content to fall flat. Your visuals have to pull more weight in a virtual setting, so think about how your images move and how they build upon each other, or how you can incorporate videos more effectively. Maybe think about mixing things up by using an avatar, like me. Our second tip is organizing your training. Training often contains a lot of information in a short period of time, which can be overwhelming for attendees. To help your audience better understand the material, we recommend treating your training program as a journey with clear milestones so people know where they are and where they've come from at any given point. In a virtual setting, the audience may not be in the same room together, but that doesn't mean that they are alone. It's important to be mindful that people are likely dealing with distractions and other responsibilities while at home. So reminding them where they are on their training journey can really help them orient themselves as they come and go. Our third tip is to be entertaining. Now, this might seem a little intimidating for some of you, but you don't need to be a comedian to make your remote training entertaining. The most important thing is to be authentic and add in your personality as you present. Share stories and anecdotes to help conceptualize the material in conjunction with your visuals. We also suggest resetting your audience every 12 minutes or so. After a while, it becomes harder for people to maintain their focus. So by periodically breaking up the flow of your talk with a quick Q&A, a story, or a joke, that will really help you engage your attendees. So I hope that you found today's information useful and valuable. Today's video was actually created by using DemoCreator. So let's go through it step by step. Firstly, launch the DemoCreator video presentation maker. So we'll go to Wondershare DemoCreator, and we're going to go to start a new demo project. Hey, my camera's already on. We can go up here to our camera and select what camera we want to use. We can also select the microphone that we want to use. If we want to start creating our presentation, we can go over to the plus button here, and it will give us the option, if we right click, to add a picture, add a video, to share our desktop, or to delete this frame. So I could add a picture in, three tips for remote training. I can actually change my background. If I come over to the background tab here on the right, I can choose a lot of very cool backgrounds. I have like a news studio background. I have this cool woodlands at night, forest during the day. And also, if I come up to here, I can choose something like a solid color. So I had a solid blue color as my background for my presentation that you just saw. I can also change how I am displayed on screen by using the newsroom layout, which makes me tiny in the corner, the merge display, and actually I can move myself around the screen, and I can also resize this slightly so that I'm not too big, and I can have my presentation here or here in the background. I also have the option to do full screen content. So For example, if I had my remote training, I could have myself and the remote training or the full screen of the content there, and I could just do my camera. So me full screen in the center. I can also flip my camera. If I go to here, I can flip what side I am on the screen. You can use an avatar as well. So there are a whole host of avatars that you can select. If you come over to the right, select the avatar, you can choose who your avatar is going to be. You have 3D avatars and anime avatars, which are very cool, that you can choose from as well. If you want to go back to your how you normally look, then just come over to the camera and select camera, and we are back. If we want to start our presentation, we can go to demo and record. If we press that, it gives us a countdown, 3, 2, 1. And now we're actually recording. What we're doing now is actually recording. And if we stop this, the video will export and it will save. And we can watch this back. And now we're actually recording. What we're doing now is actually recording. We can take this footage here and edit it later, which is what I did with my presentation. Also, during the recording, you can highlight key points down here by using the pen tool. And if you wanted to select something, for example, 3 tips for remote training. If you want to delete that, go back to your pointer and you can select these individually drawn assets and you can delete them just by hitting the delete button. Also, if you wanted to add visual elements and you wanted to have transitions, you can come over to the transition button and you can select how, when you move to the next frame, putting in an extra picture to show you that when you move between the different frames on the left hand side here, you can use these transitions to bring in the new content. So I think I used fade on all of my new slides, so each of my slides faded in, apart from where I did the edits as well. You can also add in other visual elements as well. If you come to the objects, I used this arrow sign, so all you have to do is click on that and it brings it on, brings it onto your screen, and you can move that around onto your screen. So all of these cool elements, you can download them. Once they're downloaded, you can drag them onto the screen. So very useful to try and add life to your videos and just more movement, particularly for your virtual training videos. Okay, so in these 4 easy ways, anyone can create an eye-catching training video without any editing experience at all. So I hope you're now familiar with how to productively train your teams and clients online. I hope you found today's video useful. If you did, don't forget to give us a like. And if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the little bell for notifications. So that's all from today's video. I'll see you in the next one.